the third session, Contribution of Concrete to Sustainable Construction. The moderator of the session is Mr. Manuel Lascaro, Executive Director of FIH.
Thank you for coming again. Please take your hands. Okay, we're going to talk about the contribution of concrete to sustainable construction. Concrete is the most used material in the world. The contribution of the material goes beyond a simple mixed proportion. Concrete brings communities together and helps to develop the entire life with the schools, offices, hospitals, roads, and buildings. That's the zone in which the next two presentations will stay. I'm going to introduce our two speakers of today. Mr. Rifkin is a Lebanese American who was born in northern Lebanon and lived in Houston, Texas. He studied computer science at the University of Houston, Texas, USA, and then received his MBA from American University of Beirut, Lebanon. He started his career in the oil business. In the year 2004, Sam moved to Abu Dhabi, where he started a career in the ready mix industry with Al Fala Ready Mix as an operations manager and an assistant general manager. 2 years ago, Sam became the marketing manager of Al Fala Holding. Currently, and after the recent expansion of Al Fala in KSA and Qatar, Sam is currently serving as a regional marketing manager for Al Fala Holding. He is going to talk about sustainable concrete in Mazdar City. Please welcome Sam.
Kit.
Hi, everybody. Now I don't have to say anymore. I want to thank you all for being here. I want to thank Rabia for putting me right after lunch. You know, this is kind of tough because I think everybody want to take a nap, so don't make me hate him. Actually, I want to do a little entertainment for today. I want to bring a couple of belly dancers. So to do a show for you, but Rabia wouldn't let me either. He said, you know, that will distract you from presentation. That was all I did. Well, anyways, we would like to thank the great mentors, NRMCA and the Dubai Municipality for the guidance and being the beacon for the listeners in the GCC and the region.
To build the world's first carbon neutral zero waste city.
It's fully powered by a renewable energy. It's located in the heart of Khalifa Bay in Abu Dhabi. Masdar has its own solar farm, actually, and I think they set up so far 88,000 solar panels. This produces about, I think, about 17,500 megawatts hours of clean electricity that is used now. That's yearly. And they offset about 15,000 tons of carbon, which is a lot of carbon. Masdar Al-Falah. Why did Al-Falah choose Masdar? Actually, we didn't. Masdar chose Al-Falah. Al-Falah means, you know, being a big player in the area, or in the country, actually. Now, concrete being the second most consumed commodity in the world after water, and concrete mainly being the cement. Cement production is responsible for about 5% of the world carbon emissions, and that's a lot. So naturally, Masdar wanted to reduce the carbon in the concrete used in the city, of Masdar. You know, we spent about 11 months of negotiating with Masdar, in our R&D department of Masdar, the demolition agreement, which intends to reduce more than 30% of the carbon while maintaining all the derivative activity in the company. Research and development, obviously, we did not create Masdar Mixes and went on business as usual. After that, we had we have done a lot of research and development. We created an R&D shop in collaboration with Masdar, and there was a lot of testing and research with Masdar Institute of Science and Technology for sustainable concrete. In fact, we're doing a project now with Masdar Institute of Science and Technology. But I cannot tell you about this, because if I do, then I have to clear over. And there's a lot of, I think just a few people are waiting, everybody else is asleep. I told you that the activity was going to be asleep. Anyway, it's a good project. It involves 3D, that's all I can tell you. But you do not need glasses for that, so. The Masdar City objectives, operating with emission, with zero emission, operating with zero waste, significant reduction in construction footprint, leadership in achieving sustainable business, value as a center for clean technology, demonstrate a new urban model that inspires sustainability lifestyle. This also set a new trend of sustainability in the construction industry in the region. Now we see it on a day-to-day basis almost. Everybody wants to fly or fly ash in the mixes, and you know, Dubai Municipality has all the credit for that, mostly in Dubai. We appreciate that. What is sustainability? Sustainability is responsible integration of environmental protection, social equity, and economic growth. That's what leads to society, economy, and environment. There's another one here. Okay. Again, what is sustainability? To secure fully achieved sustainability objective, we must alter the business as usual decision model and integrate sustainability into the core decision process. This, of course, affects the cost, scheduling, and quality. But not necessarily in a negative way. We need to make sure that we understand that. Because a lot of people think sustainability is expensive. It really isn't. However, we now must consider the short and long term impact of environmental, social, and economic priorities. contractor. Not only us, suppliers, also the contractors who work in Mazda City, they must also do it. I will go through this quickly for the permanent regulation. Permanent regulation usually considers the annual summary for monthly financial activity, highlighting that activity data, emissions, monthly emissions, breakdown, and perimeter emissions. Road calculator and flight calculator, that's very important. Road calculator and flight calculator, and the vehicle efficiency. Refrigerant is one of the aspects that we consider on not particular trade on stuff that uses, which is high in CO2. Emission factors, highlighting the emission source. Steps towards sustainability. The challenge was to set maximum limits to the carbon footprint. So, what do we do to do this? Erecting patch plant at site to reduce travel distance. That's what the FADAT is in Mazda City. That's what I'm talking about. The use of Euro 5 engine trucks, the use of recycled aggregate and material, complying to concrete temperature control without the use of ice. We were not allowed to use ice on Mazda City, and that was by itself a challenge. We set the limit a little higher than the usual, but it was done and we did it perfectly. The use of reclaimers, recycled return materials in the trucks and separate. The use of water treatment plants to recycle the water. So we use recycled material, recycle the water. With sustainability in mind, AlphaClean was born. So, what is AlphaClean? AlphaClean is our product that we're proud of and we created at the beginning for Mazda and then it was used in other projects that we supply from. What we're going to do today is we're going to take a case study that we used for Mazda when we created this. I just want to bring to your attention that this case study is based mostly and we're doing mostly to show the carbon footprint that and to show how much CO2 we save in every mix. So, we have here the, we use the mix, this is the substructure exposure glass, which it was very severe. We use the 30 Newton, 40 Newton, and 50 Newton. The mixes for Mazda were 40% OPC plus 60% GBS. And the same for, this is all the same. Slide. And we compare the mixes that we use for Mazda and the mixes with OPC. We're going to concentrate mostly on the CO2. If you can see the CO2 here per ton, and the 3020 we used was 0.173 compared to 0.333 in the conventional mix, 0.192 for the 40 Newton compared to 0.571. And 0.157 compared to, why do you guys think it's so small, huh? 0.350. So, you know, you can see it from there, right? And, of course, there's tax involved in this for the CO2 tax, which is 35 dirhams per ton. And you can see that in the mixes we have for Mazda, the tax was less, so 6 dirhams compared to 11. 6.7 compared to 12.9, 6.9 compared to 14.5. So you can see in the graph the CO2 footprint for substructure. This is mixes 30, 40, and 50. And the red is for the slide, 60% slide, and the yellow is without the slide. And you can see the CO2 footprint is bigger. Now this is the same mixes, the exposure glass very severe, and we are doing this for the durability test. As you can see, the chloride permeability and water absorption. We took samples on different days, 1 day, 3 days, 7 days, 28 days, and 56 days. You can see, even if it's 28 days, and I want to stress that mostly for GGS or slag, this region don't get by more than 28 days. If you compare them, you can see the average for 13 days for 13 is 32. It's higher than the OPC, of course, and then 46. But if you look at the 56 days, you see that the difference is very, it's almost similar, 41 compared to 41.5. 64.5, 62.5, compared to 67. We can see here the strength of concrete, and this is for the substructure. Also, this is 1 day, 3 days, 7 days, and 28 days. And if you can look at it, you can see the difference between the mixed wood slag and early stage, you can see that the mixes without slag, they really become strong fast, but then at the end it will become almost uniform. This is the RCP. You can see the RCP for the mixes with slag, 224, 711. That's not 711 in this case, so 429. And then you can see Modak, UBS or the Modak slide, which is very high for the RCP. Probably the one that would show it. Ten more minutes?
Not good.
Let's slow down something. The water absorption, we have 1.2, 1.2, and 1.34. The 30, 40, and 50 with the slide. Of course, it's a bit higher than the without the slide. This is the another mix for another case study. The glass monument. We use 50% GDS for 50% slide instead of 60%. And you can see that there's, let's go back also to CO2. The CO2 here would be a little bit higher. And the CO2 tax will be higher than the other ones. For the, you can see here in the graph also. This is the same as the other one, but this is with 50% slide instead of 60%. Also for the strength, we achieve on 56 and 28 days, we achieve the higher strength because we use less slide. Even though in the first one we used the all the strength requirement. I'm not going to go into all the things because this is always the same. You can also see the difference in the compressive strength here, the graph. And here we see the RCP. You can see it's a little higher than the one with 60% slide. Same for the water absorption. This case study is for the same 30, 40, and 50, but this one is with the internal exposure class, which is low. And you can see also the CO2 is a little bit higher in the mix, so which means the rate is a little bit higher. Also the same. You can see here that CO2 is higher than the durability in this and the strength. Almost the same for. It becomes more uniform here because we're using less than 40% of all the slag. You can see here the RCP is a little higher because we're only using 40%.